Thank you. Thank you. Christ hast revealed thy glory among the nations. Preserve the works of thy mercy, that thy church throughout the world may persevere with steadfast faith in the confession of thy name, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. And Jacob rose up that night and took his two wives and his two women servants and his 11 sons and passed over the ford Jabbok. And he took them and sent them over the brook and sent over that he had. And Jacob was left alone. And there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day. And when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh, and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said, "Let me go, for the day breaketh." And he said, "I will not let thee go, except thou bless me." And he said unto him, "What is thy name?" And he said, "Jacob." And he said, "Thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel, for as a prince hast thou power with God and with men, and hast prevailed." And Jacob asked him and said, "Tell me, I pray thee, thy name." And he said, "Wherefore is it that thou dost ask after my name?" And he blessed him there. And Jacob called the name of the place Peniel, for I have seen God face to face, and my life is preserved. And as he passed over Peniel, the sun rose upon him, and he halted upon his thigh. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. letter of Paul to Timothy. But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them, and that from a child thou hast known the holy scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. All scripture is given by inspiration of God, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and they shall be turned unto fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Savior Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke. And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint, saying, there was in a city a judge which feared not God, neither regarded man. And there was a widow in that city, and she came unto him, saying, avenge me of mine adversary. And he would not for a while, but afterward he said within himself, though I fear not God, nor regard man, yet because this widow troubleth me, I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary me. And the Lord said, hear what the unjust judge saith, and shall not God avenge his own elect, which cry day and night unto him, though he bear long with them? I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, shall he find faith on the earth? The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to the Lord Christ.
Thank you.
the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. If I look a little puzzled this morning, it's because I'm not quite sure what I want to do with the sermon. I got like two different ways I could go, and I'm not sure which one, so I'm just going to... Not sure how it's going to land, so hold on.
Amen.
I am reminded, as a boy, going to visit my grandpa Costanza in Queens. And every morning, we would come down for breakfast, and I would find him in the living room praying. Praying hard. And he would always say, in this mixture of an Italian and New York accent, Kevinucci, if that was me, always pray. And as I got older, and I'd call him on the phone, hey, Grandpa, how are you? And he would talk about everything, then he would always say, Kevinucci, make sure you pray. And as I hear the scriptures this morning, I hear his voice. Kevinucci, make sure you pray. And I think, why? Why? Sometimes I feel like when I pray, I am literally talking to myself. Have you ever felt that way? Like you pray, and you get done praying, and you think, well, that was a waste of 5 minutes of me sitting here, my eyes closed, talking to myself. Because you feel like sometimes your prayer gets this far. And you pray, and you pray, and you pray, and nothing seems to happen. I'm just being real. Is that okay? Because we can make stuff up and say everything works out great. Sometimes our prayers just don't get anywhere. Well, we heard in the Old Testament about Jacob, who's fighting with the angel. You know, I won't let go until you bless me. Like fighting, physically fighting to get an answer from God. And then we read in the gospel, Jesus tells the parable, which is, I don't quite, it's out there a little bit, about this judge. The judge cares nothing about justice. The judge cares nothing about doing what's right. All the judge cares about is being a judge. He likes being a judge. I don't really like the work of being a judge, but I like being a judge. He doesn't care about people. He doesn't care about God. He doesn't care about doing justice. He just cares about when is tea time and when do I get off this bench to go do what I want to do with my life. And this woman comes to him and she says, Judge, I want vengeance. We don't know what happened. We don't know who the suspect is in the crime, if it's a crime. We don't know if it's a he or a she. We know nothing except that this widow goes to the judge and says, I want justice. And the judge says, go away. And she comes back. And the judge says, go away. And she comes back and the judge says, somebody got it. Okay, good. Go away. And finally, he says, I'll tell you what, I'm going to give you what you want just because I want you to go away. And we sometimes make the comparison of God to the judge. But in fact, God is the contrast of the judge because God does care. Because God does want to hear from us. Because God does want to know what's on your heart. The problem is this, and here is the failure of the world today, and it's not just today, but it goes back a long time ago. It's about the transaction. The widow went to the judge for a transaction. I want justice. Finally, the judge says, final justice. How many times do we go to God as a transaction? I remember as a kid, how many times would I go and say, God, if you give me, I will love you forever. I remember, anybody remember the cartoon Voltron?
Oh, yes.
Thanks be to God. When I was a kid, yes, the lion one. When I was a kid, it would have been like fifth grade. They had come out with the giant Voltron. And it had all of the lions and it shot rockets. And I wanted one so bad. Like I wanted, it was a die-cast metal. I wanted the die-cast metal Voltron. And I kept saying to my dad, I really want Voltron, Dad, I want Voltron. And I'd pray, dear baby Jesus, please give me Voltron. You know I want Voltron. And one day my dad picked me up from school and he took me down to some really weird place in New York City. And he came out, it was like Rolltron. It wasn't Voltron, it was like something else. It was a knockoff, the missile didn't shoot very far. It was just, it was not the right thing. But it was close, and that's the best you could do at the time. And I got Rolltron instead of Voltron, but it was fine. But I remember praying to God, please give me this Voltron, and I'll love you forever kind of a thing. And we still do it as adults, don't we? God, if you give me this, then I will love you. It's like a transaction. Like we get a God ATM card that we go and we swipe it. And as long as we have credit on our ATM card, and how do you get credit? Well, you come to Mass, you, you know, pay your tithe, you support your church with all the things, and you get credits on your God ATM card, and you go and you swipe the card, and God gives you a certain number of what you want, and then you got to start all over again when it's a new stewardship year. And that is not how God works. God is in relationship. God doesn't always answer our prayer on our time or in the way we want, but God always answers our prayer. I think about those who we've loved that maybe have passed away, and I think, God, why couldn't you heal them? Like, let's just be honest. Why did you have to take them? And I got to, this is just for me. I'm not saying you got to think the same way I think. But for me, in those moments, I also pause and think, if we believe in eternal life, if we believe in resurrection, God is really saying to us, oh, I have healed them in a way that you cannot. I don't know why God does what God does, but I know that perseverance in prayer, that praying and believing and trusting in God, and trusting in God's ability, and trusting in God's love, and trusting in the work of the Holy Spirit, and trusting that we serve a God who is greater than we are, a God who formed us and made us wonderfully made in His image, a God who loves us enough to come and send His Son to die for us so that we can have eternity, that God I trust. And that God I hold on to. And sometimes we got to wrestle. And sometimes we got to be persistent like the widow and not give up. Like Winston Churchill said, never surrender. Don't let the devil tell you that your prayers are empty. Don't let the devil tell you that God doesn't hear your cries. Don't let the devil tell you that there's no hope, because there is a hope. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus Christ and His righteousness. I'm going out of town soon, so I'm going to preach. Don't forget that you serve a God who loves you more than life itself and hears you and feels your pain. We don't serve a God who is absent, like the judge who is transactional, but a God who is present. A God who wants to be in relationship and wants to hear from you. Not just when we want something, but sometimes He just wants to hear a, hey God, I love you today. You know, this might sound corny to you, but every time I come into church in the morning and I reverence the altar, some people kind of laugh at me, but I always reverence it. I say, good morning, Jesus. And when I leave, I say, good night, Jesus, you got it. And it sounds kind of corny, but that's kind of how I talk to Jesus sometimes. Like, sometimes when I'm in my office alone and things are going the way they go sometimes in the church, I say, Jesus, this is yours. You better come up with something because I got nothing. Be in relationship with God. He wants to hear from you. He loves you. And never give up.
His grace is always enough. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of His
offered to the greater glory of God, and in thanksgiving for the glorious resurrection and ascension of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in thanksgiving for the gift of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, and in thanksgiving for all the blessings of this life, including those for whom we offer our thanksgivings now, silently or loud. For those celebrating birthdays this week, especially Lee, Jared, Curtis, Elise, Catherine, and Peter, and all those for whom we offer our thanksgivings now, silently or loud. For all those celebrating anniversaries this week, we offer thanksgivings now, silently or loud. We remember those for whom our prayers have been asked, especially those on the parish prayer list. For all those affected by the coronavirus pandemic, and for all those for whom we pray now, silently or aloud. Among them, we remember Joseph, Teresa, Chuck, Patrick, Richard, June, George, Raymond, Pam, Ed, Ron, and for all those for whom we pray in love. We pray for the repose of the souls of the recently departed, and for those whose year's mind falls this week, especially Clifton, Robert, Margaret, Anthony, and for all those we remember now, silently or aloud. For the departed members of the Guild of All Souls, for the departed sisters and associates of the Holy Nativity, and for all those who have died in the war in Ukraine, and for those who have been victims of violence in our own country. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace. Please be seated. No, not everybody. You're way early. Go ahead and have a seat. Go ahead and please be seated. Thank you. Continuing our prayers on page 11. Father, we pray for thy grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world. Give us grace to do thy will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in thy sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
That light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise thee for thy saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in thy heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of thy people. In the multitude of thy mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to thee for help. For thou art gracious, O lover of souls, and to thee we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walk from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God devoutly. Almighty God, Father
of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge that you weigh all our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time mysteriously have committed, and have thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We further repent in our heart of sorrow.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
the peace of the Lord be always with you.
You guys in the offertory, you're going to have a seat. Let's go ahead and sit. When the offertory starts, then you come on up. They're excited. They're ready to go. Few announcements. First off, let me get to my announcement page. I know that you have your sermon notes section filled with notes. I have announcements. Monday morning prayer at 8:30, with evening prayer at 5:30. Special note for this Tuesday and next Tuesday. There will not be mass, but there will be evening prayer at 6 o'clock. Same time, same place, different format. So it'll be evening prayer instead of mass at 6 o'clock for the next Tuesdays while I am away. And then Thursday morning prayer at 8:30, and evening prayer at 5:30. A couple things coming up in the meantime to make note of. On 10/31, on All Hallows Eve, we'll have our great candy giveaway. We'll have a table set up out front. Come dressed as whatever you'd like, and we will give candy away to all the adults and kids in the neighborhood or anybody who comes by. We just set up here, and Peter has a loop of the organ playing really like scary music. And it's a great time together, so come and join us. But in order to do that, we need two things. We need you, and we need candy. Bring candy to the office so we can give it away, particularly peanut butter candy is always good. And I will make sure that it goes to the right person or people. So just bring your candy to the office to Kelly. Kelly's in the office Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday from 9 to 5. And she'll make sure that we have it together for 10/31. Also, wear your costumes. I'm going to dress up as a priest. Or maybe the fat friar from Harry Potter. I do have that costume, too. So come have a good time again. It'll be fun. And then on Tuesday is All Saints Day. Tuesday we'll have low mass at 6 p.m. for All Saints here. And then on Wednesday is All Souls Day at 6 o'clock. That'll be a high mass with choir and music. So here's the thing, here's where I'm asking for your help. All these colors don't just magically change on their own. Bill and I have tried. We have stood here and said, please change, and they don't unless we do it. So that week, which we call the fall trigger week, there's a lot of change. We go from green to white to black, then we gotta change back again. So if you are coming to All Saints Day on Tuesday, it can help for a few minutes after Mass. You know, many hands make for light work, and it really is true in this case. If we have a few people helping, we can do transition quickly. Here's the why All Souls is such a big transition. It's not just changing all the linens and all that to black, but we have to move these candles, which weigh about 8,000 pounds apiece, to the center and move the fulcrum in, and there's other things we have to take. All the candles are changed, the crucifix is changed, everything gets changed. So if you can help us, that's great. And then after All Souls Day, it all goes back. So there's a lot to do. So if you can help us at that time, that would be fantastic. Also, if you have a loved one that you would like to add to the necrology for All Souls Day, please email the office or call or come by and let Kelly know the name of your loved one that you'd like to be added to the necrology list for this year. So I will be starting vacation here in about 45 minutes. I am excited to go away to celebrate my wife's birthday. And it is the first time that our family has gone away since we left Ohio to move here. So we're looking forward to going back to Ohio, not to stay, but just for vacation. So please pray for us. And I thought I was going to get a Sunday away, but apparently I'm not. I'm preaching at All Saints this coming Sunday. So I'll be doing something. So I'm looking forward to that as well. So next Sunday, you will have Father Andy Mead. We'll be celebrating Mass. Father Mead was the former rector at Church of the Advent in Boston, as well as St. Thomas in New York, two of probably the big jewels of the crown of the Anglo-Catholic tradition within the Episcopal Church. And so he will be celebrating next Sunday. I know you appreciate him, but don't appreciate him too much, because I'd like to come back. So keep him in your prayers as well. I'll pray for you all as you pray for us, and we look forward to seeing you all when we get back and gathering again together. Any birthdays or anniversaries this week? Come on. This is her natural hair color. Anybody else? It's just us. Gracious God, thank you for Mr. Daughter. For her love and for her service in your kingdom. Bless her this year, watch over her, protect her. May her love for you grow in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. She's the only one that I do that to. All right, last but not least, we have prayer shawls. Prayer shawls are really cool, and let me tell you why they're really cool. Because they're kind of sacramental in a way. You say, geez, how can a prayer shawl be sacramental? Well, I'll tell you. A sacrament is something that represents something that it is. And this represents what? It represents comfort. It represents prayer, it represents the warmth of community, and in fact, that's what it does. It warms, it keeps safe, it protects in a way, it gives comfort, it's soft and gentle. So we have four prayer shawls that Melissa has made, and I know that she would love to have more people help her make prayer shawls. Because this is a wonderful thing to bring to those who are sick, who are in the hospital, or those who can't get out, and to let them know that they are loved in a very tangible way, that they're being prayed for. So if you know, I said so, it's not really so, but if you know how to make these,
or if you want to know how,
see Melissa and we can get a prayer shawl group going. The idea is that we can make enough of these that we have them in stock, so to speak. And when I go make a visit, or when our team goes to make a visit, they can grab one and bring it with them as a gift with their visit. So that's kind of the plan. So let's stand together and ask God to bless these gifts. The symbols of religious devotion that you have brought to be blessed express your faith in various ways. They serve to bring to mind our Lord's great love for us, or to increase our confidence in the power of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all of the saints to help us. When, therefore, we call down God's blessing on these religious articles, our foremost concern must be that our Christian lives bear out the kind of witness we give by using them. Let us pray. Blessed be your name, O Lord. You are the fountain source of every blessing, and you look with delight upon the devout practices of the faithful. Draw near, we pray, to these your servants, and bless these shawls that were lovingly made to be used as a symbol of faith and devotion to all who receive them. Grant that we and those who receive these instruments of love and prayer may find peace and hope, that they may strive to be transformed into the likeness of your Son, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever. Amen. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us as an offering and sacrifice to God. Now you can take up the offer.
Thank you.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Son Jesus Christ to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. The night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as you shall drink it, in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. Humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. By whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in
gifts of God for the people of God.
Watch this.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to us, who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members and corporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace,
that we may
continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory,
the world without end. Amen.
So now, my beloved, the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, descend upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.